screaming out, we can be heroes everywhere we go. We can have all that we ever want. Swinging like Ali, knocking out bodies, standing on top like a champion. Keep your silver, give me that gold. You'll be remembered when I say we can be heroes everywhere we go. Keeping us down is impossible, cause we're unstoppable.
Backstage, and I think George has a interesting fact he wants to share with y'all.
Yeah, Annie forced this little secret out of me. I actually kind of enjoy game shows every now and again.
What kind of game shows?
You know, a little like Wheel of Fortune, you know, kind of like that. Anyone else like Wheel of Fortune? Not very many. Oh, there we go. All right.
Well, lucky for you, George, we are going to be kicking off pre-session with a little fun trivia game. So can we go ahead and have our contestants come to the stage, please?
Everyone give a hand for our contestants as they come up on stage.
All righty. So this is how this game is going to work. In a moment, we are going to have a picture or a question pop up on the screen. Then our teams are going to work together and try to figure out what the answer is to that picture or question. Now, y'all can participate as well. You can shout out them if you know the answer too. So do we think we're ready? Awesome. Alrighty. And go ahead, let's give a round of applause to our amazing AV table for all they've done today. Awesome, we can go ahead and switch to that first question. What does this slide represent?
We got a team here, I saw a hand first.
The state officers?
Yes, this is the 2023-2024 Iowa FFA State Officer Team. So George is gonna go ahead and give them 1 point. Alrighty, we can go ahead and switch to our next slide. What is this?
Convention app.
Yes, this is the convention app. And if you haven't already, please, please, please download the WOVA app. You can go ahead and look up on the screen here. It's important that you download this app so you can keep up with all of the exciting things that are happening at this year's convention. So, George, just go ahead and give this group a point. Awesome. Next slide. Who is this? Oh.
It's Canyon Huntington.
Yes, let's give Canyon a round of applause. Oh, really?
He's from our chapter.
How awesome is that? Canyon's from this chapter. So Canyon is currently serving as a national officer, and he is representing Iowa FFA so well. So go ahead and give them a point, George, and we can move on to our next question. What year was the first Iowa FFA convention?
1933.
Not quite. Is there any other questions?
1929.
1929 is correct. That is when the first convention was. All right, go ahead and move to our next question. The pin worn by Green Hands is made of what type of metal?
Bronze.
Bronze is correct. All righty. Come on, guys. We have to keep up with this group back down here. How many paragraphs make up the FFA creed?
All right.
Five.
That is correct. Good job. All righty. Moving on. What chapter is the Iowa FFA president from?
South Winnesheek.
Yes, that is correct. That is Holly. Let's give Holly a round of applause. What an amazing state president. Alrighty, moving on to our next slide. How many taps of the gavel call a meeting to order?
I saw them.
Yep, there's them.
Two.
Two?
Two.
Yes, that's
two
correct.
Was the answer.
It is two. What is the FFA symbol for knowledge and wisdom?
It was that group.
This group?
Yep.
The owl.
The owl is correct. Great job. Alrighty, so how many words make up the FFA motto?
Is it 16?
16 was the
that
answer.
That is not correct.
Not
Does anyone
quite.
Else want to guess?
Let's see. This group, what do we got?
Nine?
Not quite, not quite.
12.
12 is correct. Alrighty, and that was our final question. So let's give our contestants a round of applause. Now our winner today is going to get a conference t-shirt. So George, do we have a winner or do we have a tie?
We have a tie between our East Union group and our West Dubuque group.
Awesome, go ahead and step forward if you won. Awesome, let's give them one more big round of applause. So if you enjoyed watching pre-session today, you're in luck because George and I will be back here when, George?
We will be back here tomorrow at 12:30, so don't miss pre-session. It is gonna be awesome, but make sure you're here at 12:30 tomorrow afternoon.
But until then, who is ready for the second general session of the 96th Iowa FFA Leadership Conference? Awesome, thank you everyone.
Let me see you do the count.
Loose. The secretary's desk has a few reminders at this time. All leadership development event participants receiving a gold rating must report to sections 131, 132, and 111. As a reminder, please turn off all cell phones. Laser pointers are prohibited in Hilton Coliseum. All donors report to the seating desk located by the secretary's desk for further seating instructions. And will Joanna Cook please report to the secretary's desk at this time? Thank you.
Mr. Worldwide to infinity, you know the roof on fire. We go boogie, oogie, oogie, jiggle, wiggle, and dance like the roof on fire. We go drink, drink.
I'll be at the FFA Enrichment Center in about 5 minutes, but there's a list of things to do for state convention on my desk. Could you guys go grab that and start working on it before I get there? Yeah, a list. Okay, thanks, JD. See you soon. Bye.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah, I'll grab the list, don't worry.
I got the list!
Huh, this is a pretty interesting list, but I guess if Holly wants us to do it,
we're gonna have to divide and conquer.
Oh no. They took the wrong list. I hope they didn't get too far ahead of me.
Disconnect from all intellect and let the rhythm affect. You lose the inhibition, follow your intuition, free your inner soul and break away from tradition. Cause when we be out,
bum bum bum, ba-dum ba-dum. A duck walked up to a lemonade stand and he said to the man running the stand, hey, bum bum bum, got any grapes? The man said, no, we just sell lemonade, but it's cold and it's fresh and it's all homemade. Can I get you a glass? The duck said, I'll pass. Then he waddled away, waddle, waddle.
Let's go crazy, crazy, crazy. I walked into the party. I seen something I never saw. Everybody was moving, grooving. Girls, they were dancing on the bar.
Country roads, take me home to the place I belong.
Left to do though.
One, two, three.
Travel on, there's one day here and the next day gone. Sometimes you bend, sometimes you stand, sometimes you turn your back to the wind. There's a world outside every darkened door where blues won't haunt you anymore. Where the brave are free and lovers soar. Come ride with me to the distant shore. We won't hesitate to break down the garden gate. There's not much time left today. We'll be right back.
FFA members, advisors, and guests, get ready for the 96th Iowa FFA State Leadership Conference as we welcome your 2023-2024 Iowa FFA State Officer Team. Your North Central State Vice President from the Nevada FFA Chapter, Josie Kelly. Your Northwest State Vice President from the Sibley Cheatin' FFA Chapter, J.D. Bramer. Your Southeast State Vice President from the Cedar Rapids Prairie FFA Chapter, Will Belaschik. Your Southwest State Vice President from the Audubon FFA Chapter, Collin Bauer. Your Northeast State Vice President from the Vinton-Shelsburg FFA Chapter, Annabelle Newton. Your South Central State Vice President from the East Union FFA Chapter, Lizzie Hadley. Your state reporter from the Columbus FFA chapter, Emma Humphrey. Your state secretary from the East Buchanan FFA chapter, Lauren Beyer. Your state president from the South Winneshiek FFA chapter, Holly Schmidt. And our retiring board of director chairperson from the Creston FFA chapter, Mrs. Kelsey Bailey. Ladies and gentlemen, your 2023-2024 Iowa FFA State Officer Team.
The convention hall will come to order. We are now holding the second general session of the 96th Iowa FFA Leadership Conference. Madam Vice President, are all officers at their stations?
I shall call the roll of officers, determine if they are at their stations, and report back to you, Madam President. The Sentinel.
Stationed by the door.
Your duties there?
Through this door pass many friends of the FFA. It is my duty to see that the door is open to our friends at all times and that they are welcome. I care for the meeting room and paraphernalia. I strive to keep the room comfortable and assist the President and maintaining order.
The reporter.
The reporter is stationed by the flag.
Why stationed by the flag?
As the flag covers the United States of America, so I strive to inform the people in order that every man, woman, and child may know that the FFA is a national organization that reaches from the state of Alaska to the Virgin Islands and from the state of Maine to Hawaii.
The treasurer.
Stationed at the emblem of Washington.
Your duties there?
I keep a record of receipts and disbursements, just as Washington kept his farm accounts, carefully and accurately. I encourage thrift among the members and strive to build up our financial standing through savings and investments. George Washington was better able to serve his country because he was financially independent.
The secretary.
Stationed by the ear of corn.
Your duties there?
I keep an accurate record of all meetings and correspond with other secretaries wherever corn is grown and FFA members meet.
The advisor. Here by the owl. Why station by the owl?
The owl is a time-honored emblem of knowledge and wisdom. Being older than the rest of you, I'm asked to advise you from time to time as the need arises. I hope that my advice will always be based on true knowledge and ripen with wisdom. Madam Vice President, why do you keep the plow at your station?
The plow is a symbol of labor and tillage of the soil. Without labor, neither knowledge nor wisdom can accomplish much. My duties require me to assist at all times in directing the work of our organization. I preside over meetings in the absence of our president, whose place is beneath the rising sun.
Why is the president so stationed?
The rising sun is the token of a new era in agriculture. If we will follow the leadership of our president, we shall be led out of the darkness of selfishness and into the glorious sunlight of brotherhood and cooperation. Madam President, all officers are at their stations.
Thank you, Madam Vice President. The secretary will call the roll of members.
I am pleased to announce that at this, the second general session of the 96th Iowa FFA Leadership Conference, there are 6,598 members, advisors, and guests from 247 chapters present. Madam President.
Thank you, Madam Secretary. FFA members, why are we here? To practice brotherhood, honor agricultural opportunities and responsibilities, and develop those qualities of leadership which an FFA membership possess. May we accomplish our purposes. I now declare the second general session of the 96th Iowa FFA Leadership Conference duly open for the transaction of business or attention to any matters which may properly be presented. Members, advisors, and guests, welcome to the second general session of the 96th Iowa FFA Leadership Conference, sponsored by the Iowa Farm Bureau. It's truly remarkable to witness Hilton Coliseum filled with a sea of blue jackets, each representing a future leader in agriculture. Through FFA, we have the opportunity to unlock our full potential and discover our passions in agriculture. So let's get excited as we officially begin the second general session of the 96th Iowa FFA Leadership Conference. Your second session chairs come from the eastern side of our state. The first is constantly talking about his cows and the Iowa State Cyclones. Your second chair is an Eastern Iowa girl who loves everything Taylor Swift, agricultural education, and crumble cookie reviews. It is never a dull moment when these two are together sharing their passions with others. I am proud to call them my teammates. Iowa FFA, please put your hands together for your second session chairs, your Southeast State Vice President, Will Vlasic, and your Northeast State Vice President, Annabelle Newton.
Yeah, Breaker 1-9, this here's the AB. You got a copy on me, cowboy? Come on.
Yeah, 10-4, AB, for sure, for sure. By golly, it's clean, clear to Hilton, come on.
Yeah, it's a big 10-4 there, cowboy.
Yeah, we definitely got the front door, AB.
Mercy sakes alive, looks like we've got us a convoy.
He's pounding down, loaded up and trucking. Are we gonna do what they say can't be done?
We've got a long way to go and a short time to get there. I'm eastbound, just watch no bandit run.
That was a close call.
Good thing we made it on time. Looks like the rest of our convoy made it here before us. I guess we'll go ahead and get started.
We've got a jam-packed session ahead of us. We'll recognize newly chartered chapters, anniversary chapters, and hear some retiring addresses from some of our teammates.
We will also be recognizing our donors, proficiency winners, and hearing the long-awaited leadership development event results.
Advisors, members, and guests, buckle your seatbelts as we begin our road trip through the second general session of the 96th
Iowa FFA Leadership Conference.
For years, the Iowa FFA has relied on important partnerships to create new opportunities and strengthen existing programs. Farm Credit Services of America continues to serve as a large supporter of agricultural education and the Blue Corduroy. FFA members, advisors, and guests, please help me in thanking Farm Credit Services of America for their generous support.
Many lenders work in agriculture, but only one works for it. Mission-driven and owned by the producers we serve, we help customers manage risk, grow their success, and achieve goals. More than just another lender in agriculture, we strive to be its most valued. Discover a lender that works for you at Farm Credit Services of America.
Leadership Conference celebrates the many tremendous accomplishments that members and their chapters achieve throughout the year. Every chapter develops their premier leadership, personal growth, and career success when they zip up the Blue Corduroy. We are excited to welcome more chapters into the Iowa FFA family. Please join me in celebrating the first of many accomplishments for these new chapters. Will the Secretary's desk please read the names of our newly chartered chapters?
Our newly chartered chapters are Center Point Urbana, Clarksville, Holy Trinity Catholic, West Central. Congratulations to our newly chartered chapters.
In 1974, gas cost 53 cents, Kung Fu Fighting had just been released, and Richard Nixon was the president. Like our country, this chapter have become stronger over the past 50 years. Will the Secretary's desk please read the names of the chapters celebrating their 50th anniversaries?
The chapters celebrating their 50th anniversaries are Bellevue, Fort Madison, Tri-Center at NEOLA. Please congratulate these chapters on their 50th anniversary.
In 1949, 1,427 members from 152 chapters gathered to recognize the amazing successes of members across the state. For the past 75 years, these chapters have continued to succeed and prosper. The Iowa FFA honors the chapters, advisors, and members who will be a part of these 75th anniversary chapters. Will the Secretary's desk please read the names of our 75th anniversary chapters?
Chapters celebrating their 75th anniversary are North Union at Armstrong, Colfax Mingo, Clayton Ridge, South O'Brien, and Wilton. Please congratulate these chapters on their 75th anniversary.
My name's Will, and this is State Convention.
Hey, Iowa FFA, I'm Annabelle, and you're watching the 96th Iowa FFA Leadership Conference.
Hello, my name is Kevin Cooper, the Nevada High School FFA advisor. In 2018, there was a rebuilt and restored Bobcat skid loader at the Story County Fair. It was an impressive project for a seventh grade 4-H girl. Since then, this young woman has done a couple tractors, a multitude of leadership contests, and several FFA career development events, state fair ushering, and served twice as a district officer. This girl shows true dedication in all things she puts her mind to. It is my pleasure to introduce Josephine Kelly, your state vice president from the North Central District.
Imagine you're sitting in your middle school classroom, eyes glazed over, wondering how you're ever going to use PEMDAS in your everyday life. Now, imagine your mom's giant face driving past the window. This was a common sight for middle school Josie, and in moments like this, the entire class would turn around and begin to tease me, because let's just say, when your mom's face is plastered onto the side of a real estate moving trailer, everyone in town knows who she is. Now, I didn't think the embarrassment could get much worse. And then her real estate team upgraded to advertisements that played during halftime of the football games. I never thought I was going to escape the embarrassment and be able to pave my own path. Growing up, I didn't have many opportunities to make a name for myself. I blended in, stayed part of the crowd, just Andy and Jennifer's daughter. But something changed the summer before my junior year of high school. I was still riding the high of being newly elected as the 2021-2022 North Central District Secretary, and I was feeling super confident. But as the days of this success got farther away, I could feel my confidence fading. This became evident when I was making the 45-minute drive down to the Iowa State Fairgrounds, where I was going to be participating in the ushering program for the next 2 weeks. As we got closer, my heart began pounding harder and harder. Was anybody going to know who I was? Was I even going to have any fun? As my mom helped me lug my things up to the bunkhouse, I could feel my anxiety mounting. But obviously, I was not about to tell her that. But my nerves began to subside when I was met with the sight of Trisha Kellner, one of my newly elected district officer teammates. Now that I had a buddy by my side, we headed up to Hillcrest, the meeting spot for all of the ushers. We began some nervous conversation and waited for further instruction, but now that I had a buddy by me, I was feeling pretty calm. That was until Trisha, my new safety blanket, was taken away from me, and we were put into two completely separate groups. I took a look around, and I did not recognize a single face. So many new people, so many unknowns. I wanted to call my mom and have her come and pick me up again.
Luckily, I did not do that. Fast forward to the night of the Blake Shelton concert. I began branching out and meeting some of the people in my group. One of those individuals was Wiley Ray. Wiley is someone contagious that you can't help but laugh when you're around him. And I admired how everyone Wiley met was already considered one of his friends. This night, while working closely with someone I didn't know, was monumental for me. Because I became just Josie in this moment. Soon, we started giving each other tons of sarcastic comments and formulating our own inside jokes. But this gave me the momentum to branch out and meet two new people. This time, it was Jennifer and Harley. These two radiate kindness and positivity, and I'd met them when I was in my bunk. I was tired from a long day's work at the Iowa State Fair, and the last thing I wanted to do was to put myself out there. Luckily, in typical Harley fashion, she blew through the doors of my insecurity and all but drugged me onto a shopping trip. There was never a specific moment in time. I knew I wanted to be friends with these people, but I could never imagine my life without them. Before, I never thought I had what it takes to get to know new people without them knowing my family. I thought I had to be highly interesting, intelligent, witty, and funny, and in this moment, none of those were adjectives I would have used to describe myself. But what these three individuals taught me is that I didn't have to pretend to be someone I wasn't. What lured me into these relationships was their never-ending kindness and authenticity, and with time, these are two traits I have begun to feel confident in portraying. Before I knew it, I started to invite Reagan, Braxton, Ben, Sam, Harley, Allie, Alice, Jenny, Justin, Milo, Alice, and many, many more into my community. Because I knew I had these people behind me, I continued to pave my own path. The work I put into paving my path became evident when I was out running some errands with my family. We had bumped into someone I had ushered with, and the next words out of their mouths were words I will never forget. "You must be Josie's parents." I was no longer confined to the name my parents made for themselves, and I was known as the person I made myself out to be. When I left ushering, I felt like I had lost a community. The people who had helped me thrive and flourish were no longer there. I only see these individuals once, maybe twice a year. But as I've grown, I've realized that community is so much more than the people who are physically surrounding us. Community are the people who are there to support us through our highs and our lows. The people that we can call to confide in. Those individuals who are there to support us no matter how far away they are. And I'm proud to say that throughout my year serving in this organization, I have been enclosed in the names of the people I hold closest to my heart. People like Trisha, people like Jennifer, people like Harley, and people like Wiley. The people who continue to have my back. Iowa FFA, do not fear building relationships with others. Be like Jennifer, Harley, Trisha, and Wiley. Build your community, be your authentic self. Iowa FFA, pave your path.
Josie, is that one of the new Richardson 220 hats?
You know it.
Where can you find those?
You can find them at the Sheeman Building across from Hilton Coliseum at the alumni store.
FFA chapters and members across the state are showing every day what it truly means to live to serve. Over the year, Iowa FFA members partner with Meals from the Heartland to fight hunger in their communities. They come together at state convention to continue giving to families in need. Please help me in welcoming Hunger Fight Manager, Mr. Georgie Filber.
Let's give it up for Will. Isn't Will doing a great job today? This guy's awesome. Iowa farmers feed the world. Scratch that. Iowa FFA members feed the world. Over the last 12 years, Iowa FFA chapters have faithfully packaged millions of meals with Meals from the Heartland. This year's been no different. Just today, we finished packaging 200,000 meals with over 1,000 FFA members right here in Hilton Coliseum. Thanks to the generosity of Cargill, Meals from the Heartland and Iowa FFA came together to package meals and change lives. Through the generosity of Cargill and the hard work of 1,000 FFA members, 770 kids will be fed for an entire year. But what's really amazing is that we're actually packaged more meals now outside of Hilton each year than we do inside this building. That's because Iowa FFA chapters all over the state are taking matters into their own hands and feeding the world right in their own high school gyms. Does this require planning, funding, and a little bit of sweat? Of course. Is it worth it? Absolutely. What other project could your FFA chapter take on that would make a bigger impact than feeding a starving child in war-torn Ukraine or a drought-stricken country in Africa? What other project can mobilize your entire school to make a difference with their own two hands? What other projects put your FFA chapter in a position to lead the way and make such a big impact? Iowa FFA, we have officially crossed the 5 million meal mark. I encourage you to join the fight against hunger. As Iowa farmers feed the world, Iowa FFA members feed starving children. Thank you.
Mr. Filber, on behalf of the Iowa FFA Association and its over 19,000 members, we want to thank you and Meals from the Heartland, as well as Cargill, for showing us what service truly looks like. Please accept this conference gift as a token of our appreciation. Let's give another round of applause for Georgie Filber and Meals from the Heartland.
Governor Kim Reynolds appointed Mackenzie Snow to lead the Iowa Department of Education beginning on June 26th of 2023. Director Snow is committed to ensuring all children have access to a high-quality education that inspires them and prepares them for the future. As director, her work is grounded in high-quality teaching and learning, family and teacher empowerment, evidence-based innovation, college and career pathways, transparency and student funding and supports. Director Snow began her work in the classroom teaching remedial courses at the University of the Free State in South Africa. She served as Virginia Deputy Secretary of Education over early childhood education through post-secondary pathways and as New Hampshire Division Director of Academics and Assessments, Special Education, Career Development, Adult Education, Wellness and Nutrition following her confirmation. She also served in the federal government as a special assistant to the president at the White House Domestic Policy Council, senior advisor at the Office of Management and Budget, and policy director at the U.S. Department of Education. Prior to government service, Snow was a policy director at the Foundation for Excellence in Education. Snow has been named a Fulbright grantee, Rotary Ambassadorial Scholar, and Bush Institute and Clinton Foundation Presidential Leadership Scholar. She is a proud fifth-generation Midwesterner. Please help me in welcoming Director Snow.
Thank you, Northeast Vice President Newton, for the kind introduction. It is an honor to be with you all as we celebrate the 96th Iowa FFA Leadership Conference with Iowa's incredible FFA student leaders, dedicated ag teachers and FFA advisors, and valued business and industry partners. When we visit and learn from students, families, and teachers across Iowa, we always discuss how to best connect the classroom with the workplace. It's a top priority for Iowa education to empower all students with multiple pathways to post-secondary success. And that's what FFA is all about, ensuring that each of you are supported with the knowledge and skills to succeed in what comes next, to realize your unique vision for your life with the post-secondary and career decisions that are right for you. So first and foremost, thank you. Thank you for choosing Ag Ed. Thank you for supporting a skilled workforce and a strong regional and state economy. And thank you for investing in yourselves and our students, and thus in the future of agriculture in Iowa and our world. When I first joined the team this summer, I had the opportunity to spend time with some of you at the famous Iowa State Fair. FFA students showed off their livestock, a refurbished 1947 tractor, and so much more. And of course, the Avenue of Breeds and the Animal Learning Center. The yak and the duck pond were not to be missed. We see that through Ag Ed programs across the state, FFA students demonstrate strong competencies, a love for agriculture, and great leadership skills and confidence. And that work, your work, is why agricultural education continues to grow across Iowa, with more programs and more students with strong agricultural knowledge and transferable skills, and thus providing food sources not only in the United States, but for countries worldwide. As you know, the vision for All In for Ag Ed is striving towards 100% access to high-quality Ag Ed programs in Iowa. That includes making student leadership organizations like FFA and hands-on, minds-on, supervised agricultural experiences and work-based learning opportunities a reality for all students across Iowa. We know that's an ambitious goal, but this is a very determined room full of powerhouse students, educators, and partners. And Ag Ed is already making great strides. Students across Iowa enrolled in nearly 22,700 ag-related courses this school year. Can we please celebrate that? Currently, we have 263 Ag Ed programs in Iowa, which is the greatest number since 1987. I think that deserves some applause, too. And FFA, Iowa's largest career technical student organization, has broken last year's record membership of over 19,200 students with a new record of 19,736 students. What does almost 20,000 students sound like? Woo! And boy, do we know that the demand for a strong ag talent pipeline is high. According to the USDA and the Coalition to Support Iowa's Farmers Ag Intel, agriculture adds $39.7 billion in total value to Iowa's economy. That is almost $40 billion with a B, not across the nation, but here in Iowa. And 20% of Iowans earn their living in an agriculture or ag-related industry. Additionally, about 61% of new graduates come from degree programs in food, agriculture, renewable natural resources, and the environment, preparing students for in-demand careers spanning crop management, predictive analytics, animal health, plant sciences, renewable fuels, environmental engineering, information technology, advanced manufacturing, business, importantly, ag ed, and so much more. Families, industry, and Iowans continue to depend on you and on Ag Ed. You, Ag students, educators, and partners across this room and across Iowa are making the difference. So again, thank you. Thank you for your dedication to one another, to Ag Ed. Thank you for pursuing transformational learning opportunities, including supervised agricultural experiences and work-based learning. Thank you for keeping Iowa an international leader in Ag Ed and thus in ag industry. And thanks for being here today to invest in yourselves and thus in our future. Please enjoy these 2 days of learning and fellowship together.
Director Snow, on behalf of the Iowa FFA Association, we would like to thank you for your continued support. Please accept this conference gift as a token of our appreciation.
As agricultural education continues to grow in Iowa, so does the need for new teachers and retention of current educators. The Golden Owl Award, presented by Nationwide, shines light on those agricultural educators who go above and beyond, inside and out of the classroom. 7 teachers were selected and awarded a $500 prize, along with entrance to the final selection stage. Will the Secretary's desk please read the name of the 7 finalists?
From the North Central District is Carlton Ness, South Hamilton School District. The winner from the Northeast District is Barb Lemmer, Linmar Community School District. The winner from the Northwest District is Matthew Schroeder, Esterville Lincoln Central Community School District. The winner from the South Central District is Ashley Wolf, Grinnell Newberg Community School District. The winner from the Southeast District is John Daniels, Belle Plaine Community School District. The winner from the Southwest District is Casey Allen, Lennox Community School District. The post-secondary winner is Amber Griman, Hawkeye Community College. Please congratulate our finalists. And the 2024 Iowa Golden Owl Award winner is John Daniels from Belle Plaine FFA.
Speak after this. Yep. Mr. Berklin, thank you for Nationwide's continuous support of the Golden Owl Award. Recognizing the great work of our agricultural education teachers is extremely important, and we appreciate your excellent support of agricultural education and FFA. On behalf of the Iowa FFA Association and the Iowa FFA Foundation, please accept this conference gift as a token of our appreciation.
Banana, orange, grapefruit, grape, kiwi.
I would say fearless. I'd be cheese because it goes with everything.
go-to cheer when I'm cheering on Collin Bauer, the best basketball player in the world, is one, two, hoop, there it is.
Robert Jones, Curtis Jones, Taman Lipsy, Keyshawn Gilbert, Demarion Watson. Dang it, that's bad. Only six? Angus, Aberdeen, Semitol, Highland, Manning Jew, Holstein, Guernsey, Jersey, Charlay.
Hannah A, Polly, Autumn, Henry, Adam, Harrison, Amara.
Since 1986, the Iowa FFA Foundation has helped support the Iowa FFA Association and its over 260 chapters across the state. They have done this by building relationships with partners and finding new ways to work towards the future. At this time, I am pleased to introduce to you the Iowa FFA Foundation past president, Jason Berkland.
Thank you very much for having me tonight. I first want to start off with a big thank you to all of our donors. These investments support programs that are life-changing for our students. Because of their generous giving, we were able to, in the matching program, we were able to pay off over $1 million on our FFA Enrichment Center while continuing to support our future leaders. And speaking of the matching program, we have just 10 months left in this amazing program, matching 50 cents on every dollar donated to the Iowa FFA Foundation. This means it's all hands on deck, because the saying goes, many hands makes light work. If you'd like to know more, please visit the Iowa FFA Foundation website or reach out to our staff or our many board members. Thank you and enjoy the amazing leadership conference.
Please help us in recognizing the Iowa FFA Foundation Board of Directors. Julianne Johnston, Ron Zelli, Kelsey Bailey, Eric Weave, Chad Hertz, and Marty Schwager. Thank you, Mr. Jason Berkland and the Foundation Board for your service to the Iowa FFA.
The milkman, the paper boy, evening TV. Did I get delivered here? Somebody tell me, please. This old world confuses me. Flowers as green as you've ever seen. And a bird knows your tune. Then a little voice inside you whispers.
Major donors of the Iowa FFA are those who give over $500. Their dedication continues to provide countless opportunities through scholarships, conferences, experiences, as well as the FFA Enrichment Center. At this time, please direct your attention to the screen to recognize our major donors.
Let's give our donors one more round of applause.
My name is JD Bramer. I'm currently the Northwest State Vice President. I'm 19 years old, and I dedicate this FFA speaking to my dead monkey. This is Brass Monkey by the Beatles. I've got a castle in Brooklyn, that's where I dwell. Brass monkey, that funky monkey. Brass monkey, that funky monkey.
The Iowa FFA Gold Standard Program is a way for corporate sponsors to support the overall mission of the Iowa FFA Foundation with different tiers of giving levels to support any type of budget. We are proud of all of our Gold Standard partners and their commitment to this wonderful organization. Please help me in recognizing our 2024 Iowa FFA Gold Standard partners.
Eagle Partner, Iowa Farm Bureau. Our Emblem Partners, Des Moines Area Community College, Heartland Co-op, Iowa Soybean Association, Hertz Farm Management. Our Rising Sun Partner, U.S. Army ROTC. Let's give a round of applause for our Gold Standard Program Partners.
The Forever Blue Society was created by the Iowa FFA Foundation to honor those who have invested in agricultural education through estate planning or other investments designated for the Iowa FFA Foundation for members across the state of Iowa. Today, we are proud to recognize those new members of the Forever Blue Society through their generosity. Will the Secretary's desk please read the names of those being recognized for the Forever Blue Society?
Those being recognized for their gifts as part of the Forever Blue Society include John and Sandra Bonner, Robert and Charlotte Tanruther. Thank you to these Forever Blue Society members for their generous gifts.
So busy with all the state convention prep, so I hope you guys don't mind, but we're going to take a little bit of time to write some thank yous that we need to catch up on.
Josie, hit the music.
Thank you, Iowa FFA Banquets, for making sure that my belly is always full of pulled pork sandwiches, chips, and lemonade wherever I go. Thank you, Iowa State Fair, for really meaning nothing compares to the amount of fried food being consumed when you stay at the State Fair.
The Secretary's desk has an announcement at this time. Due to the pending severe weather conditions in the area tomorrow, please note the following changes to events at the 96th Iowa FFA Leadership Conference. The Iowa State University CALS tours for Tuesday, April 16th are canceled. The Iowa Degree Reception on Tuesday has been moved to Stevens Auditorium beginning at 1:30 p.m. Please enter through the north entrance. The reception program will occur at 2:30 p.m. Following the short program, the Iowa Degree Picture will also take place in Stevens Auditorium. Finally, there will be no outdoor food trucks on Tuesday, April 16th. Hy-Vee will move its grill shack and Hi-Chai trucks indoors to the west side of the outer concourse, where limited menus will be available for purchase. These are all of the announcements at this time.
Good evening, Iowa FFA. It's good to be back in James H. Hilton Coliseum and seeing the blue corduroy here today. On May 3rd, 2004, 20 years ago, I went from being an 8-year-old single child to a big brother of twin boys. One would think that an 8-year gap between my brothers and me would make for a lack of connection between us. If anything, it's made us grow. I have taught them, and they have taught me. I never would have thought that these two boys would become the best men at my own wedding. I am blessed to have them both, but the one I'm going to introduce to you tonight is one of a kind. At 3 years old, he taught himself how to read and do math by watching ESPN Sports Center, seeing the scores roll across the bottom of the TV all day long. This jump-started his competitive passion for sports and many other things. He has made the difference by being a young servant leader in the classroom, on the court, and in the church. He truly has gone the extra mile that a lot of us in the Bauer family haven't done, and we are so very proud of him. Agriculture is a passion of his, especially the education of it. He's going to Iowa State right now, majoring in ag education, and he will be someone that people will learn from. While he knows he has more growing to do, my brother is way ahead in aspects of his life, especially in his faith in God. The most rewarding thing I've received from him is seeing him walk down the same path that I did almost 10 years ago by being in this same position. I'm so proud of you, and our family loves you so much. So with that, I would love to introduce to you your 2023-2024 Southwest State Vice President and my brother, Collin Bauer. He gives his retiring address titled, Put Your Shoes On Right.
Have you ever had or witnessed a game-changing moment? I know that right now we are sitting in a coliseum where more game-changing moments have happened than one can remember. Who here has ever witnessed some Hilton magic? In one of my last high school basketball games, my team and I made one of these moments happen that would make the internet go crazy. Now let's see it again in slow motion here. Maybe. Yup, that was me making an impossible buzzer beater, giving our team the win. Now, to make a moment like that happen, they require a little bit of luck, but every single detail of every second mattered. One icon I've looked toward here recently is the Wizard of Westwood, also known as John Wooden. While traveling across this great state and serving all of you this last year, John Wooden has served as an inspiration for me. Now, John Wooden was a basketball coach for over 40 years on both the high school and collegiate levels. But what he was most famous for were his 10 NCAA national championships with the UCLA Bruins. You may be wondering how one can achieve greatness like this. Well, for starters, Coach Wooden grew up on a small family farm with no electricity, where he woke up every single morning with his dad to go milk the cows and do other chores. From a young age, John Wooden understood the importance of every detail. But picture this, a group of UCLA freshmen with the likes of future Hall of Famers, Bill Walton and Kareem Abdul-Jabbar walk into their first practice knowing they're in the path to becoming champions. The players sit anxiously in the locker room, waiting for Coach Wooden to walk in and put them through the most intense workout of their entire lives. But instead, Coach Wooden did something different. He pulled up a chair, took off his walking shoes, grabbed his basketball shoes, and said, "Your first lesson is how to properly put on your shoes." The players felt belittled by this, and they didn't understand how this was important to them at all. I mean, they played basketball almost every day of their lives. They have put on their shoes countless times. If I were them, I would be feeling a similar type of way. How many of us have ever put on our shoes while standing on the heels of them so you can slip on like a flip-flop, kind of like this? Yeah, me too. Let's just say that I used to drive my dad crazy during high school because of the inconvenience of sitting down and tying them. Sorry, Dad. Now, why would something so small and from a surface level seem so unimportant We live in a world where the small things may seem insignificant or ridiculous. Sometimes at school, we may lose points on a test for not writing our name on top of it, or get in trouble for wearing our hats in the classroom. In the FFA world, sometimes the difference between winning and losing in a contest is tapping that gavel one extra time or wearing our proper official dress. These small things may seem generally unimportant, but it's crucial for us to realize that the seemingly small things in life make the largest impact. We can also use these small things to make an impact on the people around us. About 2,000 years ago, my Savior taught me that under any circumstances, we should love the people around us as ourselves. Yeah. There are small acts of kindness and love that we can perform every single day to show these people that we care. Whether that means we smile at someone in the hallway at school or simply ask them how they're doing, these small things will make an impact on others. Putting these dress shoes on right may not seem like that big of a deal, but these are just one piece of the puzzle that puts my entire official dress together. John 1 taught his players to put their shoes on right, to put them in the mindset to analyze each and every detail, no matter how small. Hilton Coliseum, how will you remember to do the small things right? It doesn't matter if it's when we're interacting with our peers, going about our day as usual, or even putting on our shoes. These small acts must be acted on with intention, because every single detail of every moment serves its own purpose. Because the seemingly small things in life make the largest impact. IOFFA, embrace the details, be intentional, and put your shoes on right.
The whole great state of Iowa, giving members advice along the entire way. I really wish there was just a way that we could give all of that advice at the same time.
I totally agree. You know, life is like a box of chocolates. You never know what you're gonna get.
Always stick to the four main food groups: candy, candy canes, candy corn, and syrup.
You know, Collin, if you ain't first, you're last. Always remember to have fun and be yourself. At the 96th Iowa FFA State Leadership Conference.
We recognize excellent partners as the Blue and Gold Award recipient. Those who receive the award have recently launched their partnership with the FFA and understand how important it is to invest into tomorrow's leaders. We appreciate their never-ending support, and without them, we would not be where we are today. Will the Secretary's desk please read the names of this year's recipients?
This year's Blue and Gold Award goes to Great Caterers of Iowa and John Deere FFA alumni and supporters. Great Caterers of Iowa has given significant support to the annual Blue Jackets Black Tie Gala. They have helped the foundation save nearly $100,000 in expenses. John Deere FFA alumni and supporters donates their time throughout the year contributing to Team Ag Ed. Please give this year's Blue and Gold recipients another round of applause.
The Iowa FFA is an incredible organization, but we couldn't do all that without the help of some important individuals. We would like to recognize those amazing individuals who help us create such a great organization. Please join me in celebrating the work of our Distinguished Service Award recipients.
This year's recipient of the Distinguished Service Award is Kelsey Bailey, past president of the Association Board of Directors. Congratulations to Kelsey Bailey, the recipient of Distinguished Service Award. Your dedication and support are greatly appreciated.
Mrs. Hogman, thank you for pushing me to be the best version of myself each day. Your advice helped me through challenging situations, and I can see your passion for agriculture and FFA shine through your students. Thank you.
Mr. Daisy, thank you for being a light in and out of the classroom and a push to the organization I didn't know I needed. Your support and passion for students does not go unnoticed. I am forever grateful to call you my advisor.
Mrs. Lau, thank you for being someone I can always come to for advice and for continuing to be my biggest cheerleader even though you're no longer my advisor. You truly made the Agrim a home. I am grateful to know you're always by my side. Ms. Orr, thank you for believing in Columbus FFA and for jumping into the unknown headfirst. Your courage and dedication has always been inspiring.
Mr. Fox, Ms. Blanchfield, Ms. Goodale, Lori, and Ms. Bramer, thank you for raising me for the past 5 years. You all have seen me at my best and at my worst back in that classroom at Silvio Cheatin. And I thank you all for sticking around with me and supporting me in every crazy idea I had.
Mrs. Olmquist and Mr. Van Arnum, thank you for creating an environment for me where I always had a fighting chance. You are the people who showed me what true leadership looks like, and I'll be forever grateful to have been advised by you.
Mr. Cooper, thank you for encouraging me to take the first step in pursuing my FFA journey. You have shown me the definition of what a true leader is and never failed to continue to push me out of my comfort zone.
Mr. Cooley and Mr. Obacher, thank you for seeing the potential in me that very few saw. I'm forever grateful for the countless memories and adventures you two have granted me in and out of the Blue Jacket. I am blessed to have you two by my side during every success and learning opportunity. Thank you for the continuous support and encouragement in helping me find my passion and place in this organization and world.
Ms. Power, thank you for always believing in me, even when I didn't believe in myself. Throughout the years, you have taught me the true meaning of service, and I am so thankful to always have you in my corner. Mrs. Fleming, thank you for your dedication to the Vinton-Shelsburg FFA chapter. Your love for this organization has inspired countless members.
Ms. Brecht and Ms. Richardson, if not for your influence, I would not be where I am today. I am forever grateful for your belief in me and my ideas. I am proud to call both of you my friends. If you want to go.
Advisors and school administrators, we wouldn't have been presented any of the opportunities many of us have enjoyed through FFA. They constantly support us through our big wins and always have our backs in those tough losses. Because of our advisors and administrators, we have grown into the patient and dedicated leaders that we are today. FFA members, please join us in thanking our chapter advisors and school administrators.
Give a warm welcome to my advisors, Mrs. Anna Lau, Ms. Courtney Orr, and my school administration, Mr. Jeff Mader and Mr. Mark Yeoman.
Hilton Coliseum, please help me in welcoming my administrators, Mr. Kyle Keppen and Mr. Matt Kingsbury, and my FFA advisors, Ms. Power and Mrs. Fleming.
FFA members, advisors, and guests, please put your hands together for my high school principal, Mr. Quentin Sanderson, and my FFA advisors, Mrs. Brittany Almquist and Mr. Andy Van Arnum.
Iowa FFA, please give a warm welcome to my advisors, Mr. Fox, Ms. Bramer, Ms. Blanchfield, and Lori Kreinbrink.
Iowa FFA, it is my pleasure to introduce to you my high school superintendent, Mr. Tim Keel, my high school principal, Mr. Bill Miners, and my FFA advisors, Mr. James Erlbacher and Mr. Mike Cooley.
Ames, Iowa, please help me in welcoming my high school ag teacher, Mrs. Melissa Hogman, and my high school superintendent, Mr. Chris Eink.
Members, advisors, and guests, please give a warm welcome to my high school superintendent, Mr. Dan Fox, and my advisor, Mr. John Daisy.
Hilton Coliseum, please help me in welcoming my advisors, Ms. Erica Richardson, Ms. Laura Brecht, and Ms. Christy Thoman, as well as my school administrators, Mr. Eric Townsley and Dr. Doug Wheeler.
Iowa FFA members, advisors, and guests, give it up for my ag teacher, Mr. Kevin Cooper, and my high school administration, Dr. Christian Einsweiler, Dr. Steve Gray, and Mr. Marty Chitty.
Let's give our administrators and advisors one final round of applause.
My name is Holly Schmidt. I'm 19 years old, and I'm the Iowa FFA State President. I will be FFA speaking Till You Can't by Cody Johnson. If you got a chance, take it. Take it while you've got a chance. If you got a dream, chase it, because the dream won't chase you back. If you're going to love somebody, hold them as long and as strong as you can, till you can't.
The Honorary Iowa Degree is the highest level of recognition the state of Iowa can bestow upon a non-member. According to the state constitution, the recipient must be dedicated to promoting and improving agricultural education at either the local or state level. These recipients are huge supporters of the Iowa FFA Association and are helping us to always reach new milestones. Please help me in recognizing this year's Honorary Iowa Degree recipients.
We are pleased to bestow upon these outstanding nominees their honorary Iowa FFA degrees. James Abbas, Michael Hayden, Ben Booth, Brandy Boyd, Justin Lamb, and Murray Fenn. Congratulations and thank you for your support. Please give our honorary Iowa FFA degree recipients one more round of applause.
Our next award goes to a partner who has worked with the FFA for an extended period of time and shows members across the state that anyone can make a difference. Will the Secretary's desk please read the outstanding recipient of this year's Special Citation Award?
The recipient of this year's Special Citation Award goes to Mr. Jerry Lammers. Mr. Lammers has been an invaluable member of agricultural education over his countless years serving the Iowa FFA. We thank Mr. Lammers for his dedication to the Iowa FFA, and we are proud to be recognizing him with the Special Citation. Please help us in recognizing Mr. Jerry Lammers.
I joined FFA to help me find my voice.
I joined FFA because it's where I found my fire.
I joined FFA because I wanted to give back to an organization that has provided me with so much.
I joined FFA to help me find my place in agriculture.
I joined FFA to feel more connected to the largest industry in the world.
I joined FFA because it was a place that I could be my authentic self.
I joined FFA to find other people who had similar passions as me.
Lizzie and I go way back. To be honest, I can't remember a time when we weren't best friends. From our daily Dr. Pepper runs, to the countless hours spent at the dance studio, to jamming out to Parker McCollum anywhere and everywhere, her bubbly personality has always been the light of my day. She puts her heart into everything she does and helps out anyone she can. She has always been a true inspiration to me, and I will never be able to express how grateful I am to be able to call her my best friend.
My friendship with Lizzie has been full of Chinese food, carpools, and working at the fairgrounds for hundreds of hours in the middle of December. Through all of our adventures, Lizzie has taught me how a true leader acts through kindness, determination, and always being willing to step outside her comfort zone to try something new. Lizzie has played a huge role in my life, and I'm proud to call her my best friend.
I've known Lizzie for quite some time. I've got to see her grow up at my mom's dance studio, and even compete against her in the ring at our local county fair showing sheep. Over time, Lizzie and I have become friends, and she's someone that I've come to rely on. Although to some, Lizzie's been known as my mini-me. And while I appreciate the compliment, that girl's not living in my shadow. She's paved her own path this year and been an outstanding leader and impacted so many.
Please help us in welcoming our friend and your
2023-2024 South Central State Vice President, Lizzie Hadley.
At the lunch table in middle school, I was equipped with two things, an apple and a spoon. You see, the only physical way I could eat an apple was by grabbing my spoon, stabbing the apple, and carving out a piece. Now, some of you may be thinking that this is an absurd way to eat an apple, but for me, it was the only way. For the past 11 years of my life, I have been missing two of my front teeth. Without my outer two incisors, the ability to bite through solid foods is something that I've struggled with. However, for the past 11 years, dentists have been hard at work trying to fix some of these problems my missing teeth have been causing me and my smile. In second grade, I took a trip to the dentist's office to get my first set of braces. Now I strutted on into the office, was ready to flaunt my smile and rock the bright pink rubber bands on my teeth. And before we knew it, I felt like a queen. See, I was rocking the bright green coat,
the pink bands and the biggest and brightest smile. That girl right there did not have a single care in the world. She didn't care what people thought of her. She didn't care what her teeth looked like or how she smiled. She was happy. Now, this picture is a fan favorite for many of my family and friends. This picture shows everybody's favorite smile. But that's not my favorite smile. My favorite smile is the smile behind the camera. On that day in second grade, my mom took me to my appointment. When I was done, we walked out to the car, got in, and she turned around and told me to smile for the camera so I could show everyone my new braces. And behind her iPhone that morning, she had the most perfect smile I had ever seen. The smile that would impact me for the rest of my life, and the smile I soon one day would regret not treasuring the little time I had with it. 6 years later, I came home on December 10th of 2018 to a normal night in the Hadley house. Supper was waiting for my sister and I to get home from dance, my parents in the living room talking. Life was perfect, and the smile on my face was looking about the same as second grade. But even after a long day, my mom still had that same perfect smile on her face as she talked to me and told me, "Good night, I love you." This night in December is one I will never forget. The next morning, I would not be woken up to see my favorite smile as my mom tells me goodbye when she heads off to work. I would not be greeted by that smile when I get home from school and asked, "What's for supper?" That morning, I would never see my mom's smile again, or hear her voice again, or hug her, or ask for her advice. I would say goodbye forever. That morning, my mom suffered from a heart attack, was never able to recover, and passed away 2 days later on December 13th of 2018. For the next 8 months, I was the girl who constantly broke out into tears, would skip days and days of school, and would hide from the outside world at home on the couch with her dog by her side. The girl whose smile was missing because the smile on her face was not genuine. It was broken, still missing some teeth, but most importantly, she couldn't find a reason to smile. I was still feeling this way when I walked into the ag room for the first time that next fall. Now, I'll admit, I was reluctant to do anything in that ag room, but Mr. Cooley had a different idea. He challenged me, pushed me to succeed, and never gave me the option to give up. My friends and family soon started to realize that I had a smile that was changing. While I was going through Invisalign treatment to literally fix my teeth, my smile was getting fixed too. I was finding my reason to smile again. Throughout these past 5 years, I have found my passions, my people, and my family within this organization. I have become the person I never thought I could become. I have seen members light up the room with their smiles, describing what they learned from their SAE, their favorite CDE or LDE memory, how their advisor makes any and every day better, and how this blue jacket gave them a place in this world. We all have a reason not to smile every single day, but we have just as many reasons to smile. Where do you find your smile? In the blue jacket, on a sports team, in a club, at school, At home? And who do you find your smile with? Sometimes it's not always the smile on your face, it's the smiles of those around you. Your teammates, advisors, support system, friends, family. And sometimes it's the smiles of the ones you love the most, but their smile is a distant memory that only pictures help you remember. We spend too much time focusing our smiles around what we define them to be when we are at our lowest. We spend too much time missing the opportunities around us that could change our lives for the better. The chances to find our smiles, find ourselves. Our smiles remain what we always define them to be if we do not seek out the missing teeth. Iowa FFA, define your smile.
Throughout our time road tripping across the great state of Iowa, we've seen the hard work and dedication it requires to have a successful agricultural operation. Hundreds of hours are invested into members' supervised agricultural experiences every year. This next group of members has gone above and beyond and truly became proficient at what they do. Please help me in welcoming this next group of proficiency winners, as well as thanking our donors for their generous support of the Iowa FFA.
Now time to announce proficiency winners for this session, sponsored through the Iowa FFA Foundation through the Gold Standard Program. Let's direct our attention to the stage.
Brody Courtney of the Decorah FFA chapter is our winner in the Dairy Production Entrepreneurship, sponsored by the Iowa State University Dairy Science Club. In his SAE, he raises high-quality genetic cattle to show at various county, state, and national shows. He has learned about fitting, nutrition, and record-keeping through his project. In 2023, Courtney exhibited a class winner at the World Dairy Expo. After high school, he plans to return to the family farm to continue to produce genetically elite animals to show at the national level. Our runner-up is Angie Knapp of the West Lyon FFA chapter at Inwood.
In the area of dairy production placement, sponsored by the Iowa State University Dairy Science Club, first place goes to Caden Gunther from the Bellevue FFA chapter.
Caden works for a local dairy farm, milking 130 cows with two robots and raising 70 heifers annually. He has gained valuable knowledge in nutrition, herd management, animal health, and equipment operation. His exposure to the dairy industry has enthused him to continue exploring new opportunities within animal agriculture. His future plans include joining the family cattle operation. Our second place winner is Haley Ronnebaum from the Maquoketa FFA chapter at Delhi.
William Cronman of the Benton Community FFA chapter at Van Horn is the first place winner in the area of diversified agricultural production endowed by Hertz Farm Management Endowment. William's entrepreneurship SAE includes cattle, sheep, and pumpkin production. He also has 445 hours of placement work on two other farms. After graduation, William plans to attend Kirkwood Community College for diesel ag technology with a certificate in beef production. The runner-up is Kaya Nipper of the Maquoketa Valley FFA chapter at Delhi.
Merrick Van Gruthiest of the Rock Valley FFA chapter is this year's winner in the area of diversified crop production placement. Sponsored by the CHS Foundation, Merrick has invested over 1,300 hours working on his family's diversified crop farm. He plans to continue farming following graduation. This SAE experience has greatly influenced his desire to farm full-time. The runner-up in this area is Kale Van Sickle of the Central Plains FFA chapter at Gowrie. Olivia Cranbrink of the Sioux Center FFA chapter is the first place winner in the area of diversified horticulture, sponsored by Four Seasons Fundraising. Olivia has countless hours working on a 1-acre farm fresh flower farm. Tasks include preparing for planting, laying landscape fabric, direct seeding, propagating plants, harvesting, drying, and arranging flowers. This experience has given Cranbrink the chance to expand the knowledge and skills necessary to pursue this career. The runner-up is Justine Metchelson of the Marengo FFA chapter.
The winner in diversified livestock production, endowed by Milt Luckstead Sr., is Delaney Engler of the Calamus Wheatland FFA. She has demonstrated a wealth of knowledge throughout her SAE and can deeply portray the complexity of her program. She has jumped into the responsibilities of managing a hog site, expanding her cattle operation, and managing additional opportunities off the farm, giving her a wealth of knowledge about her SAE. The runner-up in this area is Catherine Kilgard of the Marengo FFA chapter.
Lily Henry of the Central Lion FFA chapter at Rock Rapids is the first place winner in the area of equine science entrepreneurship, sponsored by the Iowa State University Block and Bridle Club. She began her SAE by training horses along with specializing in food care. She partakes in rodeo events such as breakaway roping, barrel racing, and pasture riding. Henry has focused on improving horse health routine, efficiency, and productivity. She will be attending Dort University to pursue a degree in animal science. The second place winner is Lacey Reth from the Maquoketa Valley FFA chapter at Delhi. Leah Thayer of the Beckman Catholic FFA chapter at Dyersville is the winner in equine science placement sponsored by the Iowa Horse Council. At the age of 6, Leah began taking lessons at Blush Acres. Eventually, she became a head trainer and instructor at the same facility where she began her SAE in 2019. Leah has increased her paid placement hours as she gained additional experience. She started as an instructor and then expanded her responsibilities as a barn manager. Through her SAE, she has gained communication skills by networking with other riders. The runner-up in this area is Elena Fleming from the Vinton-Shelsburg FFA chapter.
Ryan Wickling of the Central Plains FFA chapter at Gowrie is the first place winner in the area of fiber oil production, sponsored by Iowa Soybean Association and the Soybean Checkoff. Ryan has invested over 1,300 hours in his family's soybean operation while assisting with planting, scouting, and harvesting. Ryan has learned valuable skills while operating machinery and working with others on the farm. Through working with his father and an agronomist, Ryan has increased his record-keeping ability and has become more knowledgeable about farm management. The runner-up in this area is Ben Phillips of the Akron Westfield FFA chapter.
Brady Collins of the Kingsley Pearson FFA chapter is the winner in the area of forage production sponsored by Gold Standard Partners through the Iowa FFA Foundation. Brady started his own alfalfa business in 2020 on his family farm. Over the years, he's learned how to manage weeds and increase plant growth to produce more bales. His production has increased from 400 to 650 bales per cutting. Brady utilizes social media to sell his bales to local farmers. Following graduation, he plans to attend Iowa State University to major in agricultural systems technology.
The winner in the area of forest management and products, sponsored by Gold Standard Partners through the Iowa FFA Foundation, is Seth Lauer of the North Fayette Valley FFA at West Union. Seth works with his father in the family business named Lauer Tree Service. Seth has invested 2,226 hours in his SAE and has learned valuable skills in working with customers and getting the job done. Seth operates and maintains all of the equipment for safe operation. Our runner-up is Benjamin Keeney from the Colfax Mingo FFA chapter.
Laney Knipper of the Maquoketa Valley FFA chapter at Delhi is the first place winner in the area of goat production, sponsored by Iowa Meat Goat Association. Laney's SAE consists of raising registered boar goats. As an FFA member and an American Boar Goat Association member, she has focused on responsibility and management of her herd. Through herd management, she has focused on how to increase the stability of doe pregnancy and their solution through studying ketosis and CIDRS. Laney has also presented youth workshops and education programs. Laney's future plans continue in agriculture as she plans to study at Iowa State University to major in education and minor in agricultural business. The runner-up in this area is Trell Amos from the Albia FFA chapter.
In the area of grain production, sponsored by Gold Standard Partners through the Iowa FFA Foundation, is Keaton Funk of the Central Lion FFA chapter at Rock Rapids. Keaton has focused on management, maintenance, and adoption of new tillage technologies on his family's farm located near Rock Rapids. He has gained skills and knowledge needed to be successful in grain production. The runner-up in this area is Blake Borchers of the GTRA FFA chapter at Grattinger.
Marshall Zion of the New Hampton FFA chapter is the winner in landscape management, sponsored by Gold Standard Partners through the Iowa FFA Foundation. Marshall focuses on customer satisfaction, planning, and adjusting his schedule to accommodate seasonal needs. He uses his knowledge to help his FFA chapter with landscaping competitions. Harold Moore of the Maquoketa FFA chapter at Delhi is the runner-up in this area. Let's congratulate this round of Proficiency Award winners.
Secretary's desk has additional announcements at this time. If you are the flag bearer for your chapter, please bring your chapter flag to the stage immediately following closing ceremonies of this session. Additionally, star finalist record books are available for pickup at the convention office. This is all of the announcements at this time.
I've been everywhere, man. I've been everywhere, man. Across the deserts bare, man. I breathe the mountain air, man. The travel I've had my share, man. I've been everywhere. I've been to Reno, Chicago, Fargo, Minnesota, Buffalo, Toronto, Winslow, Sarasota, Wichita, Tulsa, Ottawa, Oklahoma, Tampa, Panama, Madawa.
Hey, Will, remember that one time last week when I hit that one curb?
That one time? It's more like all the time.
Hey, you're not so talented yourself. Remember that one time you tried to back your truck into that parking spot? Didn't end too well, did it?
Hey, I thought we agreed we wouldn't tell anyone about that.
My bad. I guess neither of us are very talented drivers.
Speak for yourself.
I suppose we should probably turn it over to some real talent. FFA members, advisors, and guests, please help me in welcoming our third place talent winner, Emery Hawkins from the Centerville FFA chapter, sponsored by the Iowa FFA alumni and supporters.
Place. Are we in New York City?
Oh, Dolly, we need to get you off the farm more often. And no, we're in Ames, Iowa.
Well, what are we doing here? And why are we all wearing these fancy blue corduroy jackets?
We're at the Iowa FFA convention where we learned so much about how agriculture plays a big role in our daily lives.
Boring.
The Iowa FFA convention isn't just about agriculture and animals. It's also about meeting new people, playing fun games, and making memories that last a lifetime.
Really? Well then, maybe I just want to stay here forever.
Dolly, I'm pretty sure you're going to be going where I go. Just saying. And why would you not want to go back home to the farm?
Because I just decided that I'm too fancy.
Oh, is that so?
Yes. I want all the fancy diamonds, bags and cars, and to dance the night sleigh here in the city.
Are you sure you want to stay here? We have so much fun back home, and I'm pretty sure Dad would be upset if he loses his helpers. It's good to get off the farm and have fun with your friends, but it's also nice to get back home and help grow and feed America. I have a song for us to sing, and I think it'll help change your mind. Well, life on the farm is kind of laid back. Ain't much an old country girl like me can't hack. Tillage to rise early in the sack. Thank God I'm a country girl. Well, a simple kind of life never did me no harm. Raising me a family and working on the farm. My days are all filled with an easy country charm. Thank God I'm a country girl. Well, I got me a fine, got me old fiddle. When the sun's coming up, I got cakes on the griddle. Life ain't nothing but a funny, funny riddle. Thank God I'm a country girl. When the work's all done and the sun's set low, I pull out my fiddle and I'm rising up the boat. The kids are asleep, so I keep it kind of low. Thank God I'm a country girl. I'd play Sally Gooden all day if I could, but the Lord and my wife wouldn't take it very good. So I fiddle when I can and I work when I should. Thank God I'm a country girl. Well, I got me a fine, I got me old fiddle. When the sun's coming up, I got cakes on the griddle. Life ain't nothing but a funny, funny
money hungry fool. I'd rather have a fiddle and the barn and tools. Thank God I'm a country girl. Full city folks driving in the black limousine. A lot of sad folks singing, that's a mighty keen. Sun's lonely, tell you not exactly what I mean. Thank God I'm a country girl. Well, I got me a fine, got me a fiddle. And the sun's coming up and it kicks on the griddle. Life ain't nothing but a funny, funny riddle.
Now,
Henry, let's enjoy these last couple days here in the city, and then let's go back home to the farm. That's where I belong.
Yes, Dolly. Thank God we are country girls.
Congratulations to the third place talent winner, Emery Hawkins and Dolly from Centerville FFA on their outstanding performance.
I joined FFA to help me find my voice.
I joined FFA because it's where I found my fire.
I joined FFA because I wanted to give back to an organization that has provided me with so much.
I joined FFA to help me find my place in agriculture.
I joined FFA to feel more connected to the largest industry in the world.
I joined FFA because it was a place that I could be my authentic self.
I joined FFA to find other people who had similar passions as me.
Man, I am so sad that our second general session road trip is coming to an end. There's just so much that I love about traveling, like the scenery, the road trip music, and meeting new people wherever the road may take me. What about you, Will? Will?
Sorry about that, Annabelle. I had to stop to pick up some Casey's Pizza and Diet Coke. See, my favorite part of every road trip is stopping at the gas station for all the best snacks.
Well, good thing you made it back. Our members here today have been anxiously awaiting for the final leg of our road trip, the announcement of our leadership development event results.
Will the secretary's desk please read the results of today's leadership development events?
The following leadership development event awards were all made possible with support from our sponsors through the Iowa FFA Foundation. Iowa State University College of Agriculture and Life Sciences awards the state winners with a $500 scholarship when enrolling in the College of Agriculture and Life Sciences at Iowa State University.
Okay, so do we need to go start like...
A new beginning. A catalyst for discovery. A springboard for your future. This is a time to explore new ideas and redefine yourself. To see the world through new eyes and hear voices different than your own. This is a time to take risks and know you're fully supported. This is time to create, to innovate, to challenge the conventional. Make an impact, raise the bar. This is your time to shine and become the best you possible. Iowa State University is where this new adventure begins. Iowa State is a place that inspires you to follow your heart and blaze a path that's all your own. So create your own adventure at Iowa State University. Unlimited opportunities to challenge yourself and change the world.
The reporter's book is sponsored by Wallace's Farmer. Chapters receiving a gold rating are Albia FFA, Decorah FFA, Vin Shelsberg FFA, and DeWitt Central FFA. The third place winner receiving a plaque is DeWitt Central Hannah Grants. The second place winner receiving $25 in a plaque is Albia FFA Reagan Eads. The first place winner receiving $50 and a plaque is Vanton Shellsburg, Isabel Berger, and Juliana Lewis. The Experience the Action sponsor is the United States Army ROTC. Chapters receiving a gold rating are Central Trail, Grinnell, Benton Community, Griswold. The third place winner receiving a plaque is Central Trail FFA. In second place, receiving $25 and a plaque is Griswold FFA. And the winner receiving $50 and a plaque is Grinnell FFA. The Secretary's Book is sponsored by Iowa FFA Gold Standard Partners through the Iowa FFA Foundation. Chapters receiving a gold rating are Wilton Lucy Ramers, Osceola Big Chief, Marissa Bakley, and Court Selzer, Southwest Valley, Reagan Sontag, and Decora Annika Brinsas. The third place winner receiving a plaque is Southwest Valley, Reagan Sontag. The second place winner receiving $25 and a plaque is Osceola Big Chief, Marissa Bakley, and Court Selzer. The first place winner receiving $50 and a plaque is Decora FFA, Annika Brinsas. Ag Issues and Perceptions sponsor is the ASFMRA Iowa chapter. Chapters receiving a gold are West Liberty FFA, Osage FFA, Calamus Wheatland, and West Lion. The fourth place team receiving $50 and a certificate is Osage FFA. The third place team receiving $75 and a plaque and a certificate is West Lion FFA. The second place team receiving $100 and a plaque is West Liberty FFA. The winner receiving $150 and a plaque is Calamus Wheatland FFA.
The Treasurer's Book is sponsored by Farmers Mutual Hail Insurance Company of Iowa. Chapters receiving a gold rating are Albia FFA, Morgan Tenno, Griswold FFA, Shane Taylor, Decora, Anders Lovstoon, Wilton, Madeline Thade, Vinton Shellsburg FFA, Elena Fleming, and ESAC FFA, Evan Ludwig. The third place winner receiving a plaque is Decora FFA, Anders Lovstoon. The second place winner receiving $25 and a plaque is Albia FFA, Morgan Tenno. And your first place winner receiving $50 and a plaque is the Vinton Shellsburg FFA chapter, Elena Fleming.
The conduct of meeting sponsor is Farmers Mutual Hail Insurance Company of Iowa. Chapters receiving a gold rating are Brokaw, Montezuma, Holland. The third place team receiving a plaque is Holland FFA. The second place team receiving $25 and a plaque is Brokaw FFA at Clarinda. And the first place team receiving $50 and a plaque is Montezuma FFA.
The job interview contest is sponsored by Christensen Farms. Our gold rating individuals are South Winneshiek FFA Katrina Hagman, Marshalltown FFA Ian Meyer, Winterset FFA Carly Christensen, Fremont Mills Lillian Howe, Des Moines FFA Lillian Jaden, Muscatine FFA, Camden Furnas, in third place receiving a plaque is South Winneshiek FFA, Katrina Hagman. In second place receiving $25 and a plaque is Fremont Mills FFA, Lillian Howe. And the winner receiving $50 and a plaque is Winterset FFA Carly Christensen.
The Ag Impact sponsor is Suka Manufacturing. Chapters receiving a gold rating are Brokaw, Calamus Wheatland, Audubon, Midland FFA, and West Liberty. The third place team receiving a plaque is Audubon FFA. The second place team receiving $25 and a plaque is Brokaw FFA at Clarinda. The Ag Impact First Place team receiving $50 and a plaque is West Liberty FFA.
Individual Ag Sales is sponsored by the Gold Standard Partners through the Iowa FFA Foundation. Our gold rating winners are Southeast Polk FFA Olivia Prunty, Muscatine FFA Dakota Dulkey, Central Plains FFA Shelby Sorensen, Decora FFA Anders Lovestoon, Charles City FFA, Josette Benning. In third place receiving a plaque is Charles City's Josette Benning. In second place receiving $25 and a plaque is Central Plains' Shelby Sorensen. And the winner receiving $50 and a plaque is Muscatine FFA, Dakota Dulkey.
The parliamentary procedure is sponsored by Sukup Manufacturing. Chapters receiving a gold rating are Sigourney FFA, Brokaw, West Liberty, East Buchanan, in third place, receiving a plaque, is Sigourney FFA. The second place, receiving $25 and a plaque, is East Buchanan FFA. And in first place, receiving $50 and a plaque, is Brokaw FFA at Clarinda. The extemporaneous speaking sponsor is Growmark. Our gold rating winners are Brokaw FFA at Clarinda, Raleigh Nodwer, LaPorte Dizer, Olivia Hansen, Creston FFA, Tucker Rohrig, West Dubuque FFA, Macy Phillip, and Holland FFA, Lily Moeller. The third place winner receiving a plaque is LaPorte Dizer, Olivia Hansen. Our second place winner receiving $25 and a plaque is West Dubuque FFA, Macy Phillip. And the winner receiving $50 and a plaque is from Holland FFA, Lily Moeller. The chapter activity exhibit is sponsored by Ag Processing Incorporated. Chapters receiving a gold are ACGC at Guthrie Center, West Lyon at Inwood, Mediapolis, Sibley Ocheden, West Branch, Benton Shellsburg, Pella 179, LaPorte City Dysart, Charles City, and Cascade. The third place team receiving a plaque is Pella. The second place team receiving $25 and a plaque is West Branch. And the first place team in chapter activity exhibit receiving $50 and a plaque is Benton Shellsburg FFA.
Egg Broadcasting is sponsored by the Gold Standard Partners through the Iowa FFA Foundation. Our gold rating individuals are West Dubuque, Luke Boyle, DeWitt Central FFA, Taylor Hauser, Adele DeSoto Minborn, Kelsey Greenslade, Monticello FFA, Kendall Siebels, and Brokaw FFA, Tate and Amy. In third place, receiving a plaque is DeWitt Central, Taylor Hauser. In second place, receiving $25 and a plaque is Brokaw FFA, Tate and Amy. The winner receiving $50 and a plaque is West Dubuque FFA, Luke Boyle.
The chapter program of activities is sponsored by Growmark. Chapters receiving a gold rating are West Liberty, Lawton Bronson, Brokaw, and Cascade. The third place winner receiving a plaque is West Liberty FFA. Our second place winner receiving $25 and a plaque is Lawton Bronson FFA. And our first place winner in the area of chapter program receiving $50 and a plaque is Cascade FFA. The FFA Creed Speaking sponsor is Mintec Citrus. Individuals receiving a gold rating are New Hampton, Brenda Thonderson, Holland FFA, Jalen Dow, Wapsie Valley, Zachary Boevers, Lamoni FFA, Macy Genes, Turkey Valley, Nicholas Bernard, Grinnell, Aiden Wolf, and Nottoway Valley, Luke Kanding. The third place winner receiving a plaque is Holland FFA, Jalen Dow. The second place winner receiving $25 and a plaque is Grinnell FFA, Aiden Wolf. The first place winner receiving $50 and a plaque is Wapsie Valley FFA, Zachary Bowers. The Agricultural Career in Science Investigation is sponsored by Ag Processing, Inc. Our gold-rated teams are Audubon, West Marshall, Midland, West Liberty, and Muscatine. The third place team receiving a plaque is Midland FFA. The second place team receiving $25 and a plaque is West Marshall at State Center. And our first place team in the area of Ag CSI receiving $50 and a plaque is West Liberty FFA.
The public speaking sponsor is the Iowa Soybean Association. The gold rating individuals are GMG FFA, Anna Muzzig, Centerville FFA, Lauren Phillips, Hudson FFA, Nora Mitchell, and Tri-County FFA, Chloe Zittergreen. The third place winner receiving a plaque is Tri-County FFA, Chloe Zittergreen. The second place winner receiving $25 and a plaque is from GMG FFA, Anna Mussig. The first place winner receiving $50 and a plaque is from Hudson FFA, Nora Mitchell.
The chapter website sponsor is the Carroll Area FFA chapter. The gold rated winners are Osage, West Central Valley, Postville, Oskaloosa, Bellevue, and Ogden. The third place winner receiving a plaque is West Central Valley FFA. The second place winner receiving $25 and a plaque is Osage FFA. And the winner receiving $50 and a plaque is Postville FFA. The The Leadership Development Event Awards were all made possible with support from our sponsors through the Iowa FFA Foundation. Iowa State University College of Agriculture and Life Science awards the state winners with a $500 scholarship when enrolling in the College of Ag and Life Sciences at Iowa State University. Please congratulate all our Leadership Development Event participants.
How badly do you want to go on a shopping spree? It is now time to announce the winners of this session's drawings. The winners of our two gift cards are Cece Menching of Jessup and Zane Hoitz of Holy Trinity. If you are the winners, stop by the secretary's desk to pick up your gift card.
The secretary's desk has a few announcements at this time. If you enjoy food, music, games, and hanging out with friends, then join the members from all across the state for a members' night out at the Iowa State University at the Memorial Union. The business session begins tomorrow morning at 9 a.m. And then finally, the third general session begins at 1 p.m. tomorrow afternoon.
Well, Annabelle, it looks like that's the end of our road trip.
Looks like it. We will see you all back here tomorrow afternoon for the third general session of the 96th Iowa FFA Leadership Conference.
Until next time, Iowa FFA.
Stumble to the kitchen, pour myself a cup of ambition, and yawn and stretch and try to come to life. Jump in the shower and the blood starts pumping. Out on the streets, the traffic starts jumping. And folks like me. Working 9 to 5. Just a step on the boss man's ladder, but you got dreams he'll never take away. In the same boat with a lot of your friends, waiting for the day your ship will come in, and the tide's gonna turn, and it's all gonna roll your way. Working 9 to 5.
Secretary, do you have a record of any further business which should now be transacted?
I have a few announcements, Madam President. Due to the pending severe weather conditions in the area, please note the following changes to the events at the 96th Iowa FFA Leadership Conference. The Iowa State Cows Tours for Tuesday, April 16th are canceled. The Iowa degree reception on Tuesday has been moved to Stevens Auditorium beginning at 1:30. Please enter through the north entrance. The reception program will occur at 2:30 p.m. Following the short program, the Iowa degree picture will also take place at Stevens Auditorium. There will be no outdoor food trucks on Tuesday, April 16th. Hy-Vee will move its grill shack and high chai trucks indoors to the west side of the outer concourse, where limited menus will be available to purchase. And finally, if you are carrying your chapter's flag, please report backstage. Thank you.
Thank you, Madam Secretary. Does any member know of any new or unfinished business which should properly come before this meeting? We are about to adjourn the second general session of the 96th Iowa FFA Leadership Conference. As we mingle with others, let us be diligent in labor, just in our dealings, courteous to everyone, and above all, honest and fair in the game of life. Fellow members and guests, join me in a salute to our flag.
Test. Okay. All five people, come on up on the stage.
It's good to be alive right about now.
Five people, come right up on the stage. Make a nice straight line.
As an announcement at this time. Would the winner of chapter website please report backstage for a photo? The winner of chapter website, please report backstage
okay,
for a photo.
Okay, come on up here and get in a straight line, and I'm gonna have, show me your flag that you have your name and your school on it so you know where it's at.
Do you have it up there? Do you have your name on there? You can see it? You got your, show me where you got it.
Show me where your name and flag is.
You see it? School name. Okay. School name. Got your school name on there? Yep. Make sure you can read it. Yeah, they're starting down it. School name. That's okay. Get your school name on your flag. My group leader. There's one down here. Bring it down here. We'll get this girl here. Yes. Can you read it? She's got a magic marker. Write it down there. School name. Got your school name on there? Yeah, it's coming. She's doing that right there. And then, we need to come up with something else that goes a little longer. Because you're going to drag that on the ground. Does your advisor have another one?
She might. I can talk to her.
If not, we will steal that one of those back there.
Okay.
Yeah, write it on the tape right there. Got your name and school?
Okay, show me your name and school on all your, you can see it? Okay.
And you can write it right on this piece of tape. They'll have a magic marker there. Got your name and school? Okay, you guys got your name and school and all your deals, so you can see it? All three of you? All you guys ever got your name on there? Name and school on there, is that right? Everyone's got your name and school? name of school? Give your name of school. Okay. Well, good. You got your name of school? You guys got your name of school? Name of school, name of school? Okay. All right. So here we go. We're going to get started here. We're going to make this pretty quick. And it's going to be really important. I'm going to number you off. And then one, two, one, two. So one, the ones are going to go to this up here. The ones, two is going to go here. But we're going to start here, and we'll walk up the stage. And I think the ones go up here, so it should work out that way. Yeah, ones will go through here, and twos will go over there. All right. Here we go. I'm going to count you off. One. All right, so everyone's got your 1-2-1s. We're going to have to make two long lines here, but would all the ones step here about three steps over here, make two lines, two stay where you are, and then slide down that way. So one, slide down to the north so we can get everyone in line. Two, slide this way just a little bit. Two, just slide down here so we can all get in line and stay in your line like we picked you, or if you're going to pull in, that's fine, but make one straight line. Everyone's going to make one straight line. I have to have really good people at the beginning and real good people at the end. So we're going to work it this way. Okay. I'm going to show you this real quickly, and I'm going to show you how to hold the flag. May I borrow your flag? When you hold your flag, I expect you to follow, do the following. All right. So here's what I want you to do. I want you to put your right hand at the bottom of your flag and put it and hold it at your belt. I want your left arm, thumb down. See how mine's thumb down? Look at me. Just look at me. See that thumb down? And so you're going to hold it at a 45-degree angle. Okay? And then, so you're going to go like this. You're going to march. You can have your hand up like this. And it'll look nice. And then, let's go over here. And then watch what I'm going to do. When we turn the corner. When you turn the corner, there's some people that don't listen real well, but I know that I have a very sharp group. When you turn the corner, then you can snap the flag like this. Okay? And learn to slap the flag. Every corner, make it a quick snap and make it look showy. Tomorrow is the very first time we're doing this at the afternoon session. That means this place will be packed. It'll be full. You'll have your 7,000 people in here ready to watch this. Everybody, questions? What hand goes down here? Not on this side. Put it at your belt. Some of you don't get it. Put it right here at your belt. You don't have it at your belt. Okay. Here's what's going to happen. I'm going to take the ones, and I'm going to start with my leaders, which will be here to the north. No, I'm going to do the twos first, because then you can get out of the way. The twos, you're going to walk through this here. So here's what's going to happen.
Do you see up there where 112 is? You see where I'm pointing up there? The number ones will all be up there at 112 lined up. You're going to come right down there where 110 is. There's that come down right there. You're going to come down that aisle. Here's what so you're going to come down this aisle. So you come right here. You're going to walk back there where, is that Mr. Booth back there with a white rabbit? I can't believe that. Way back there, you're going to cross in the back. And by the way, when you go down the stairs, you're going to have someone else going down the stairs at the same time. And you descend together. You will come down the stairs together. You will snap your flags together, go to the back, cross back there where that young man has got his red shirt back to me. Wave at me right there, the guy in the black shirt. Yeah, you. There you go. You're going to cross like you pass in a car, and then you're going to come up the short aisles. And you'll come up the short aisle, and you're going to cross in front right here. You'll go around to the stairs, come up across the stairs, and you will cross on the stage and then go off underneath, smiling, looking good. Everyone is looking at your flag and your butt when you walk in. Okay, so be good about that. All right, so here we go. So we're going to practice this.